I understand, and tell me if I got this right, is that when you first started writing, you wrote for the BBC, and that you were given a list of things that were funny.
Yes, that's absolutely right, yes.
Okay, that's the difference between American comedy and British comedy. No one gives us a list of things that are funny when we started a writing job. What was this list that the government had officially determined?
No. No, I didn't like that list, but there were... And they were, in a funny way, summed up by Cambridge and Oxford when I was there. Cambridge had a real sort of system. You probably heard of the Cambridge Footlights, and you kind of auditioned for it, and they had a show up in Edinburgh. So they'd almost sort of mathematicized comedy. Every time you saw a sketch of theirs, you thought, oh, that's very highly wrought and very clever, but there was very little humanity in it. And actually, you see a lot of that in Monty Python. Not that much humanity in it.
Yeah.
And that had sort of crept into the BBC. And so when you went there, they said, well, we're doing a satirical program, and the funny things are trade unions, British Rail sandwiches, you know, the Chancellor's eyebrows. And I thought the funny things were someone who's a bit uneasy with the person sitting next door to them because they're taller than they are. Do you know what I mean? Everything I thought was funny was to do with human beings interacting and nothing to do with politics and preconception. So that was the reason I failed so badly on Weekending, the satirical radio show.